Hey everybody, and welcome back to Minecraft 1.19.4. Today we are going to be getting the house started, and we are going to be getting some mining done, and we're going to be showing some of the stuff I've been working on off camera. Hope you guys enjoy, and let's get started. Hey guys, Editing Chris here. Just want to apologize ahead of time. There are some audio issues with this video. I did my best to work on them and get them done, but yeah, sorry about that guys, but I hope you enjoyed the video.
I didn't sleep, but I'm thinking about building my house right about here. So let's get some sleeping going and then we'll get started on the build. Alright, so for this build, we're going to start it right about here. Actually, we're going to need two more, so we're going to need 6, 7. I'll come back to you guys when I have the whole base worked out. Some unwanted guests over there, so let's take care of these guys real quick. But as you guys can see, I got the base kind of laid out how I want it, and
Decided to organize this a little bit, get my storage system going. Real quick, I'm going to make another barrel. Now, this isn't like the permanent layout of this base, and even still, it's just a starter house, so it's going to be subject to change, or it may just stay this way. I don't plan on moving real soon, but you never know. Depends on how the series goes. So down here, got a smoker, got a couple barrels underneath the stairs there. Got a chest for just the natural stuff, some calcite, some smooth basalt. Some polished diorite, and then over here, just all my stone stuff. This is like a miscellaneous. This is all the wood. This is all like player useful stuff for the player to get. Mob drops, and then that one's the one I just made. Then if you come over here, all our precious materials, our first diamond, things like that. And if you come over here, this is like for enchanting. And then down here, you've got like all the food. And then this is like another miscellaneous. But I got this diorite out because I wanted to show you guys a little something. If you ever want to make a table in Minecraft and you don't want to do the traditional Minecraft table, there you go. Got yourself like a little kitchen workspace. You can take your lanterns or your torches and just pop them right up there. Give a little light, make it to where you have like your cooking food here, your prepping food here, and then all your prepped food is in here. But yeah, all we're gonna do is just pop some food, get some food cooking. This is like a majority of what I caught. These fish is like a majority of what I caught, and besides what I ate, in between the episodes when I was fishing. There's a little you guys something real quick. So I know that we talked about how the flowers could be used to make dye. So you can take the corn flour, put it in here, you get blue dye. You take the bone meal, you put it in here, you get white dye. Well, if you mix the two of these together, like this, you get two things of light blue dye. And all light blue dye is The cool thing about it is instead of losing both and only getting one die, well, using two and only getting one die, you get two dies. And I just wanted to, we're in a starter house now. I want to go ahead and get me a blue bed. Just to kind of show to myself that we've kind of moved on from the need to have a white bed. I mean, a red bed for the first bed. Show you kind of what I did. Went through, got all the torches up. So this area will start spawning a lot more mobs. At night, I'm going to go through and I'm going to clean up all the shuriken. I don't really care for a temporary, like this type of shuriken farm, so. Now I will be adding some trees back here soon. I'll be adding some trees, adding just some foliage around, and show you guys what I made. Spawner right through here. And these are what they call tinted glass. It's a little bit stronger than regular glass, being as you can break it. And tinted glass, we'll open up the recipe book here. Go here. So tinted glass is a newer block to the game right here. Those amethyst geodes that we found, they drop amethyst shards when you break them, the ones that are growing off. You put those with one piece of glass, you get two tinted glass. Very straightforward. And all tinted glass does is allow the mobs to spawn, and it keeps them in complete darkness in there for them. And then what we can do is we come down here, we look like this, we get XP, and we are killing some mobs. Now I did test it out to make sure it works, and it does. And as you see, the mobs drop rotten flesh, the stone perks I already had. They drop the rotten flesh, they drop the chest plate sometimes, zombies can drop iron, and I think only drowns can drop the copper. And we won't see any of those spawning in here because this is strictly for zombies, but as you see, they go, the way this farm works is they're standing on top of a hopper that leads into this hopper, which goes into this chest, which drains down out of this hopper into this chest. And this is just a simple way to get XP for enchanting, which definitely will help once we start getting some more gear, some more diamond tools. We'll be able to enchant more of our gear and get something better than a knockback and a looting sword, efficiency and fortune 2 shovel. We'll actually be able to roll, as they call roll enchantments, which I will show you that in a second. I'm going to go ahead and get myself back up to level 30. And it's not guaranteed that whenever they're wearing armor that it'll drop. It's just a chance, and the looting actually gives you more of a percentage to get those loots from them. Armor from zombies and stuff, it can have enchantments on it. Like these have enchantments on them. You can actually take them up here, take the enchantments off of them, and you get a little bit of XP from them. Then what you can do after that, throw that in there. We'll throw this helmet in, and it'll actually smelt the helmet down into, takes a second, a gold nugget. So that armor that you get from them, unless it's leather, can be smelted down into more useful things like gold nuggets for trading with piglins, which we'll get into that later. We'll pop this gold in here. We'll take that. And we'll grab this book back out. So what I was talking about with the books is that you can actually take them in here and you can put them in. And you can re-roll the trades. So if we go ahead and we grab another book out and we put that on there, you'll see that it gives us options for other trades. We don't currently have enough to get the level 30 trade enchantment. So we'll go out here and we'll, let me see, where is that creeper at? He's right there. Take out the creeper. There's another one. Now, creepers don't burn in the sunlight, but as long as you can keep them at distance or hit them with a knockback sword like we have, it's pretty easy to take care of them. And when it's raining, none of the mobs that were burning in the sunlight will burn because the rain automatically puts them out. All right, and we are back. All right, so if we take this and add this here, like this, we get a sharpness 3 book. And you can disenchant books just like you can disenchant tools. So let's go ahead and put our bow in here and see what we get offered. I'm breaking one, I'm breaking one, I'm breaking three. Now, we don't need unbreaking three. It wouldn't hurt for us to have it, but we don't need it. So not with our current situation, because we still got decent amount of durability left on the pickaxe. Not the best, but certainly not the worst. So while I was waiting for that stuff to smelt down, I went ahead and built a little fishing dock for us to stop our boat at and for when we want to go fishing. Now this spider is really getting on my nerves, so check and make sure a creeper's not waiting to blow us up. Doesn't look like it. Let's see where this spider is. And we'll get in, we'll talk more about horses and stuff later on. I just wanted to show you guys that they were there. Yeah, I'm gonna go caving for a little bit and see if I can find some more diamonds or some more XP. I mean, some more coal, because we are actually dangerously low on coal. As in, we don't have any. Throw that there. So I'm going to grab this fish to snack on, just to keep, just so that we can make sure that our health stays good. I'm going to grab a stack of the logs. A stack of planks, and I'm actually going to grab this back out, and I'll grab a few of these pickaxes so we can go ahead and burn those up. Grab some more fish,
We'll top off on our fish. And we'll top off on our steak. Alright, and when we come back, I will show you what we got. Now, I did want to show this off real quick. As we go deeper into the world, we run and have more of a chance of running into lava, which isn't necessarily a bad thing, but definitely something you want to be a little more prepared to deal with than I am, which that's my own fault. I forgot to bring a water bucket with me, but it's always a good idea if you think you're going to be running into lava to just carry a bucket of water with you. Chances are that if the lava is there and you fall into it, a bucket of water is going to be what saves your life. And here we go. We got some more diamonds. Let me go ahead and light up this way a little bit more. We'll come back to those diamonds in just a second. I just want to make sure that there's no chance of any of the mobs kind of catching me off guard. Because once you get down here, you got more of a chance of mobs to spawn because all around you is going to be dark. And you never want to be blown up by a creeper, especially if you're down here and you're getting diamonds or you're close to lava. It's just not a fun time when that happens. And I'm going to show you guys why I like having a fortune pickaxe, because you always get a chance of getting more. Like, I got 3 diamonds there and I only mined 2 ores. So it's always good to have a diamond pickaxe on you with fortune when you're mining these ores, because you could always end up getting more than what you were initially trying to get. All right, well, I'm going to keep exploring and I will come back if I find anything else as exciting as that lava down there. All right, guys. Now, what are the chances of that? I just moved from over there where we were mining earlier, and I went to the lowest point and started mining again. And I come down a few blocks, and there is another vein of diamond. We have 26 diamond now. We almost have enough to be fully kitted out in diamond armor. But what I'm doing right now is called strip mining, or branch mining, I think is what everybody calls it, which is where I just go, I find an area, I dig down as far as I can go, which in not sure what that is in Bedrock, but I know in Java it's roughly negative 60, and I just kind of mine along the surface. It used to be a lot more effective in the older versions of Minecraft. I don't think it's as effective now because of all the deep slate, but it's certainly still an option. And I'm just going to do this for a little while, see if I can find some more diamonds, or any of the ores that I get, I'm going to go ahead and grab. But yeah. That was just crazy because I went back to that spot where we mined and there was like 4 more diamonds sitting behind it. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and grab those and then I'm going to go branch mining, see if I can find any more around this chunk. And sure enough, I mined down and there they are. All right, guys, I'll be back. But no more diamonds yet. We're still at 26. So I'll check back in with you guys in a little bit. Alright, so I went ahead and crafted up a bucket just to show you guys that we can get buckets of lava, and I will show you some cool mechanics with that here in a little bit.
Alright, hey everybody. We are back. I went mining again, got some more diamonds, went ahead and started working on getting a full set of diamond gear made, and working on getting a full set of diamond tools made. That's all I got, guys. And hopefully you like this episode, and if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, feel free to ask me in the comments. But for now, we're going to go ahead and leave it here. All right. Later, guys.